baby. Probably in the fast car, riding with the cap off, pull off with a bad bop. Thinking, guy here capping, I am not these rappers. You gon' have to cap your ass off and back on it, big homie. How about that with that shit on? Okay, my guy sit me down and she sit on it. Get him. It's a green light, they gon' get on you. Red light, green light. Boom. To my G-Nikes. I hop out with this, with that be like. My partner won't see something killed, that's what he like. So the first try, gon' tell G how I been about them since a knee-high. Since a nappy, hair black to peon. Have emotion, I'm prime time like Dion. How she throw it, I smash from the behind. Hold up, look at the fit on me. Go get the tissue, that on me. Lie for me, die for me, kill for me. She get the in the no, she lick on me. I told her, babe, show me you love me. Show me, babe, let them know I done pub. Let them know why we. They try me and go down, they know I'm coming.
I saw the drive in him at a young age. His discipline, his willingness to learn and listen. He was just a smooth runner at a young age. I mean, didn't have to teach him a lot. It was just, it came natural. His cutting ability to cut through the holes, and he was smooth. It seemed like sometimes it seemed like it was effortless.
When I first met Moon, he was young. I would say probably seventh grade, maybe. But at that time when I met him, he was a running back then, and he was still interested in becoming better. So I automatically took a liking to him because he had that pith, that umph. He wanted something at that young age.
It's like he can change his tempo, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes he can be a silent assassin and just outwork everybody, and then he can be that vocal leader that you need in the locker room, and outspoken and everything. So I mean, he can do it all. Just on another planet.
He has a strong work ethic. He doesn't like being late, and I love that. He doesn't like being late. And when he beats me to the field, it's something that gets me even more excited.
You know, it's one of those things that he had to make a careful decision of which one he chooses. You know, so it's been a great process to have. It's been a blessing. You know, we met some great people in this process, you know. But unfortunately, at the end of it all, I think he only can choose one.
On whatever school he picks, I just hope that's where he want to go, and it's in his heart, and that he feels a family environment, he feels like he can grow and go to the next level.
It doesn't matter wherever he goes, because wherever he goes, they're going to get a champion. They're going to get a high caliber athlete. They're going to get a high caliber a person who's goal-oriented. They're going to get the whole shebang. So to me, it doesn't make a difference where he go. The only difference it makes for me is that he makes a decision based on what he wants and what program's gonna put him in the best position.
It's one thing I've always told him that once you get older, I told him, man, if you wanna be great at something, put God first and work tirelessly at what you're trying to achieve, and then you'll become great at what you're trying to do.
First, I want to thank the man above for giving me the opportunity to play the sport I love. Next, I want to thank my parents for always pushing me to strive for perfection and be the best I can be. And last but not least, I want to thank my coaches, trainers, teachers, family, and friends for always supporting me and encouraging me every step of the way. So I guess it's time to make my decision.